I'm shy. Okay, so you guys asked me some really interesting questions on Instagram. Let's jump straight into it. First question, what is my origin story? My name is Toni, I'm 24 years old. I am a Nigerian who lives in Belgium. I'm Belgian as well.
Your name is Oluwatoni
Okungbowa. Oluwatoni Ogbang Ogbede Okungbowa. My name is Oluwatoni Urbain, that's my Belgian name. Ogbeide, nobody ever calls me that, so don't you dare come in my DMs calling me that. Okungbowa, that's my full name. Okay, I'm a Nigerian who lives in Belgium. My grandma is Belgian, my mom is Belgian, so I guess that makes me Belgian as well. I grew up in Nigeria till I was 18 or 17, I don't remember. I've been in Belgium ever since then, so like 6 years. Jesus Christ, I've been in Belgium for such a long time. Anyway, I've been in Belgium for so long. I grew up in Nigeria. I have a brother, a sister, a mom, a dad. My dad passed away in 2015. That was 1 year after I was in Belgium. I don't know what you mean by my origin story. I think I could go on forever telling you about my life so far, but I'll keep it at that. That's just the basic information of who I am. Next question. What is your job and why do you do it? Okay, so I'm a co-owner of Living Tone. I own Living Tone with Louis, my girlfriend. We work together to help make people understand and feel better in their own skin when it comes to fitness and training. And, you know, kind of see the positive side about how going to the gym and lifting weights and getting stronger can actually impact you inside and outside of the gym, impact your mental health, your personal health, your confidence. I mean, I personally am someone who really suffered with a lot of social anxiety. I still kind of do, but you may not be able to tell. I don't know if that's like a defense mechanism I have for seeming so confident, but I'm not really that confident. The gym is something that has helped me gain confidence, you know, kind of like become a better version of myself, because the stronger I get, the more developed I get, I feel good in my own skin, I feel better. So in essence, what do? I am kind of like a fat loss expert and someone who takes, I'm a fitness enthusiast, and we focus mainly on women, simply because we enjoy working with women. We see how the world is kind of at a disadvantaged environment for women, because everybody has an opinion on women's bodies, on everything women related, and we want to help women see that they have that they can be empowered by themselves, and most of the bullshit they see in the fitness industry relating to women is not what it is. We just want to spread the truth about the female body, what women should and shouldn't do when it comes to actually reaching goals in relation to all the bullshit the market says, like all the fit tees and waist trainers and don't eat carbs and all that bullshit. We speak the truth. Eat what you want, you know, do the exercise that make you feel good, you will reach your goals, you know, that type of things. Don't let me ramble on too much about what I do. It's really long. My view on spirituality. My view on spirituality. Louis, what's spirituality? What would you say spirituality is?
For you, I feel like it's very interesting that you are Christian.
Mm-hmm.
And so you believe in God, Jesus, you believe in Adam and Eve and everything.
But there's spirituality and religion or religiousness.
No, but that's where I'm coming from.
Okay.
Where I'm coming to. So you believe and all that. Like when we first got together, I was not into spirituality at
mm-hmm.
all. And then I got into law of attraction and basically law of attraction. And then I actually discovered how much your religion and spirituality, as in law of attraction and stuff, overlaps. So I do think you are a very spiritual person.
I think now you say it that way, I agree.
And I also think you're a natural manifester. Like all the things you need to, like for manifesting, all the things you need to be careful of or like pay attention to, mindset and stuff, you do that already, naturally.
I do think there's a big relationship between religion and spirituality, like being in tune with yourself and the environment, the universe, how you see other people. I grew up in a very religious household, like very religious, and now I'm not as religious. Simply because like my dad was a pastor, I always went to church every Sunday, you know, that type of thing in Nigeria. Like religion is something everybody holds on to, our religion, our Christianity or being a Muslim. And I kind of grew away from that because I feel like I don't trust human beings. And when I say that, I don't mean like human beings are bad. I mean, human beings are bad, but when you look at religion, like, it's a human being preaching to a group of people. Now, if he has kind of a skewed opinion or view on something, it's going to rub off on other people. And growing up in Nigeria, I always saw, like, a view on gay people, or, you know, people who are not exactly in line with what their view is, spoken down upon. And I kind of had that opinion as well. And when I moved to Belgium, like, my view on it changed, because I saw, you know, everybody is the same, and why, even though we're preaching and trying to be religious and be good people, there's still, we still hold those negative views on certain things. And I'm like, you know what, fuck that. And then when my dad died, because all through my life I always had the view that, you know, my dad was sick, like, ever since I was young I could always remember him. He was always on a hospital bed. We had like a hospital bed in our house that he lived on. That's how bad the situation was. But in my mind, I always had that view of, you know, he's going to be healed, because that's what the pastors were telling me. But I never really, you know, I always had that view of, okay, you know what, God is going to get this done for me. And that never happened. Then my dad died, and I was like, you know what, not fuck it, but like, I started having more questions, and I kind of like went on my own journey of spirituality to just become a better version of myself and not have to be part of a greater, I don't know how best to put it, because I know my mom is going to watch this and be like, so you're not Christian anymore. I am Christian. I believe in God. I believe in whatever is out there. I believe in you being a good person, you know, becoming the best version of yourself. I always say, don't judge people because you are not perfect. Nobody is perfect. So why should you have to look down upon someone because of what they've done? That's kind of like the kind of lifestyle I live by. Like, you know, yeah, this person fucked up, but you know, you don't have to hone in on that. You're not perfect. The Bible says, let he without sin cast the first stone. Wait a minute, let me look. Everything here I could just keep talking about. Let me move away from spirituality. I think, as Louis said, I'm kind of spiritual with the way I think. That's the short answer. You juicing. No, I am not juicing. I'm never going to juice. But this is actually something very interesting, because I don't look down on people who actually use performance-enhancing drugs, because mental health is a serious thing. And if we look at how social media has portrayed different things, I'm going to say juicing as a guy, because that's what men do to make themselves look better. And women kind of feel like they have to do enhancement and, you know, get whatever, get their body done. But this is as like a result of how the world has made us feel. Like social media, you go on social media, you see this guy is so jacked. You're like, I want to be like that. You try hard, you can't get that way. What's the next thing you have to do? You know, let me just try this out and see if this helps. So a woman sees someone who doesn't have hip dips and they're like, oh my God, I don't want hip dips, you know, let me try get surgery, you know. But I don't judge people who do that. You know, you do what works for you. Get comfortable in whatever you want to do. But I personally, all my life, I always said I wanted to be the best natural version of myself. And I'm enjoying the journey, you know. It's fun. I enjoy being natural and pushing my natural limits, you know. But I don't judge whoever does whatever.
Are
you do
also
you.
Very afraid of drugs?
I'm afraid of drugs, I'm afraid of weed, cigarettes, I barely do alcohol, you know, I drink alcohol, you don't do alcohol. I'm afraid of injections as well, you know, sharp objects, I'm afraid of them, like for real, I'm scared. Do I have any insecurities? I would say physically, not really. I mean, everybody has things they want to change about their bodies, but not anything extraordinary, no, that's not the word, out of the ordinary. But I think mentally I do have certain insecurities. I'm insecure about how people view my knowledge or how capable I am when it comes to certain things. And that's something that has held me back so many times in life. I don't know if you know, but I wanted to become a footballer. But I didn't become a footballer because I was insecure about how people viewed my ability. And looking back, no matter what environment I found myself playing in, I would stand out. I was always one of the fastest, one of the strongest, technically, I wasn't the best at controlling the ball, but I was a center back, you know, so that didn't really have to come in play. But that still comes from my fear or my lack of believing in myself or even asking for help. And like, even when it comes to like social media, I know I post a lot, but before I press post, man, I've overthought it so many times. I'm so afraid of what people are going to think of me, or like just that fear, that anxiety of what if, or that holds me back so much. So I would say that's my biggest insecurity, is mentally lacking or having the fear that I'm not good enough, or people view me as not good enough, when in reality, I'm smart, I'm good, I know what I'm doing. I'm an expert in what I do, I've been doing this for so many years, but still I have that fear, I still have that self-doubt. So that's one thing I actually need to work on, which you may not know, since I try to like act like everything is all rosy and great, but I'm afraid on the inside. mentally. Moving from Belgium to Nigeria. Moving from Nigeria to Belgium. What kind of question is this? I think you had it the wrong way around. I moved away from Nigeria as like a 17-year-old boy, straight into the thick of university life. Well, no university life. I tried to study Dutch, which I failed. That's a story for another day. But I actually want to give a big shout out to my mom for teaching me how to cook and raising me the way I did, because of the way she did. Because if she didn't, man, I don't know how it turned out. Like, I went from having everything catered to me just having to live by myself and my brother. I mean, we were cooking all our meals, doing our grocery shopping. It was easy for me, I think, that transition. Also because I had my brother there. He's like my best friend, so it was easy. I mean, Louis is my second best friend, but you know. It was an easy transition, I think. What advice could you give yourself if you could go back to your 15-year-old self? You can make it. Don't doubt your ability. Don't doubt yourself. Don't diminish who you are as a person to make other people feel good or whatever. I mean, don't always listen to what adults have to say. Adults don't know everything. Adults are just children that have lived longer. And living longer doesn't mean you have lived the experience someone else has. I mean, I can give Louis experience on something in her life, but I haven't lived her life, so I shouldn't really have that sort of opinion, you know? And don't just take it into account because someone you look up to has said it. People make mistakes. Nobody's perfect. Listen to your own heart. Do what works best for you. And if you fail, you learn from it. You can't really take any L's in life. If you fail something, there's a lesson for you to learn from that. If I could go back to my 15-year-old self, I'll be a billionaire by now. Now, all jokes aside, but that's the one thing I'll tell my 15-year-old self. It's still the thing I'm still trying to tell myself now. Fulfill your capacity, your potential. You can do it. Just believe in yourself. That's the one thing. What can you say about your personal relationship with food and body? I think I have a very good relationship with food and my body. Physically, I'm enjoying life. I feel like every single day is the best I've ever been, physically, except my injured hip, which doesn't seem to want to go in because I'm not training my glutes good enough. I've been trying and trying and trying, but this left side is ignoring me. But anyway, I think like this is the best I've ever been, physically. And in relationship to food, I think I have a very good relationship with food. I love sweets, which is kind of like the downside because I tend to leave. We always preach the 80-20 rule when it comes to how you eat, but mine is kind of like a 60-40. I keep like 40% of my calories for snacks because I love snacks so much. I love ice cream, chocolate, Haribo, and you know, it's all right. You're allowed to do that. I mean, life is short, enjoy your life, but also focus on your health. The other part of your diet needs to be as good as possible. Look for healthy whole foods. Stick with that and create a space for things you love, but don't let it be the other way around. Don't have 80% unhealthy, high-calorie foods that are not necessarily full of nutrients and 20% of whole foods. Have it the other way around. What made me get into fitness, and when did I get into it? What made me get into fitness, I think it's my uncle. I used to play football, like I said, and I wanted to become better. So, you know, how do you become stronger? How do you become faster? Train your muscles. You have to find a way to train. So he used to go to the gym. I was like, you know what, let me follow him one time. And that was like the eye opener. Like, I went in there. I started doing 10-kilometer runs 3 times a week. This was while I was still going to school. 10-kilometer runs for 1 hour. I'll do that easy light work. Then I'll do some weight training, which, looking back, wasn't the best option. I mean, keep your cardio as far away from your weight training as possible. You know, but it depends on your goals. You do you. But actually, no, not you do you. Let me tell you what you have to do. Cardio as far away from your weight training as possible because you need strength. You need to be able to focus on building your muscles because your muscles are key for the way you are built, the way you perform. Focus on your weight training. Focus on getting stronger. But back then, I didn't know better. But I would think my uncle is who really brought me into it. He told me the basics of every exercise I needed to, every muscle group, and I kind of just took it from there because I fell in love with it. And at that time, the football kind of fell apart because, you know, I got called up to a trial for Nigeria's under 21. I didn't go. Then I moved to Belgium, and then the language, I was too shy when I had different trials. I was always expecting someone was going to say, you know, I see what you can do. I'm just going to give you a few months to, you know, gather yourself and then you'll make it. Nah, they didn't answer me that way. It wasn't working out because I lacked that ability. And then I really got into training seriously like 5-6 years ago, started taking it serious. I did some bodybuilding. I did one bodybuilding show, came second in the junior for Europe. It was very demotivating because I really thought I was going to win. But I was, what, 19 up against a 23-year-old. That guy had much more experience than me, but it is what it is. Has your mentality changed towards fitness, and what slash who changed it? My mentality towards fitness. I don't think my mentality towards fitness in sense of training has changed, because I've always been, you know, into all that progressive overload, getting stronger, focusing on, you know, I never used to joke around in the gym. I would go with a large group of friends, but we had the same mentality of going in there, killing it, to become stronger, to become better, to build better physiques. But I would say my mentality towards nutrition has changed, because the more we started studying about nutrition, the more I understood I was holding myself back by not eating properly, by not eating enough food, by not focusing on eating enough protein. You know, that kind of thing kind of held me back. Understanding protein distribution. But there's so much that goes into it nutrition-wise that I wasn't paying attention to before that I am now. And I see it paying off. I'm getting much stronger in a shorter amount of time than I used to back then. I mean, back then I thought I could out-train a bad diet. It wasn't working. I mean, I was still lean, thank God, but it just wasn't working, but now it is, so I'm happy. How did you meet Louis? I slid in her DMs with this emoji. Was it this emoji? Mm-hmm. I slid in her DMs. She posted something fitness related, but back then it wasn't really sliding in to be like, you know, sliding into the DMs. I was just really happy to see someone training. When it comes to gym related content, I'm like, you know, you go. I'm always
that's
excited.
That's some bullshit.
That's not bullshit, bro.
That's some bullshit. Is there anything you want to say?
It wasn't even your ass that was on your story. What are you saying? She was doing leg press and she took a picture of the leg press like this.
No.
Yes, it was.
No.
Yes, it was.
No, I don't think so.
Yes, it was. Louis, come on. I told you thumbs up. No, not thumbs up. Like this. Keep on. Keep going to the gym. Keep training. That's what it was. Why would I just jump in your DMs if you post your ass on your story? No, please. No. That's where all the other guys would have been. I would be in the other section. Like, you know, you go, you do you. The differentiation, I have to stand out, you know. Let me not just be part of the hungry guys. I wanted to meet up with her and she rejected me. I was like, you know what, it's cool. Respect. And then I stopped talking to her because of that. And then she was like, oh my God, why did you stop talking to me? She's like, you know, actually, I might have some time. I was like, okay, I see.
And you were there.
I was there. I had to be there, you know. Thoughts on calisthenics. Did I pronounce that correctly? Calisthenics. You know, the bodyweight exercises, swinging on the monkey bars and all that. I actually really like it. You know, that's a way I kind of also did get into fitness, is doing bodyweight exercises. And I think, you know, it depends on your goals. If you want to be huge, it's not really going to work out for you. It's a good way to, you know, develop yourself, develop full body control. I'm a fan of calisthenics. If you want to do it, do it. But I rather lift heavy weights in the gym. But it's actually very difficult. Don't underrate it. It's very difficult. Fitness goals. Okay. I don't really think too long term. I like to think short to medium term, because, you know, anything can happen. But before the end of the year, I want to squat 200 kg. I'm 20 kg away from that. Too many injuries have impeded my strength on squats. Deadlift 240 before the end of the year. But, you know, my hip is holding me back on squats and deadlifts, which sucks. Bench press at least 180 kilos before the end of the year. So I kind of have 6 months to get all that done. But in general, I might also want to compete again in a bodybuilding show soon. The temptation is there. I'm pretty lean. Now, I'll say like I'm like 10-11%. But like the temptation is there to do that again. Goals outside fitness. I want to be rich. I want to make enough money so that my grandchildren don't have to work. That's my main goal, you know. Nah, but for real, I want to, you know, start a family, buy a house, the same, the basic stuff, become a football manager at one point, own my own gym, you know, probably maybe even have a supplement company. And just for the record, supplements aren't so needed, but there are some good supplements, which is why I want to own a supplement company, maybe a clothing brand. You know, there's so many ideas I have, I just need to figure out which one I really want to do, which one I'm really passionate about. But right now I'm enjoying life, you know, helping people reach their goals, become a better version of themselves, you know, just getting better, especially in the gym. I'm enjoying life at the moment. Do you want to live in Belgium for the rest of your life? Yes and no. I mean, I see like my grandparents, they live in Belgium, but they also live in Nigeria. They kind of like spend half the year in Nigeria, half the year in Belgium. And that's something I want to do at some point. Get the best of both worlds. But I really do miss Nigeria, you know, the culture, the people. Nigeria is a wonderful place to be. And Belgium also, you know, has its pluses, you know. So if I could live in both the way my grandparents are doing, perfectly fine. I open up a gym in two places. It's no worries, God will provide. What interests you besides football and weights? There's nothing. There's nothing. Let me tell you what my Saturdays look like. It's typically within the Premier League, you know, Saturdays I wake up, you know, a bit happy. Around 12 o'clock, football starts. I watch one match, two matches, three matches, train, come back, fourth match, fifth match. One match is about 2 hours, so that's 10 hours of football a day, 2 hours of training. Half of my day during the weekend, on Saturdays, like that on Sunday as well, is spent enjoying football and training. Louis said if we weren't in the same occupation, she would have broken up with me by now because I just don't have time for anything else but football and training, and it's true. I love it. That's my life. Okay, all jokes aside, I really like music, I like cooking, I like food. I always thought I wasn't a traveler, but I see myself actually wanting to travel more and more. So I do think I have other interests outside just, you know, my body and football and lifting heavy weights. What?
Feminism.
Yes, it's true. If you, like I said before, the reason I do what I do is to help women actually become better versions of themselves and get more confident and, you know, just get out of that toxic patriarchal, what word can I use? That space, you know, where men go around chatting shit about what women should do. I want to help women see that that is not the case, and I feel like that's what Living Tone does. We focus on women because women deserve that, and men need to shut the fuck up. If that offended you, you need to shut the fuck up. You're one of the bad ones. Golden tip when it comes to making gains: eat enough protein, eat enough calories, progressive overload in the gym. I can't stress that enough. Focus on getting stronger. Many people are lifting weights that are too light for them. You see these guys in the gym, they've been there for 5 to 10 years and they look the same, still lifting the same weights. It's insanity doing the same thing over again and expecting different results. Lift heavier. 1 kilo heavier the next day is better. What does Dr. Greg say? Greg Doucette, what does he say?
Dr. Greg.
Train harder than last time, for real. It's that simple. Train harder than last time. Do more than you did the last time. You are going to grow. Eat more than you did the last time, you know, but with relation to what your caloric needs are. Don't just eat 5,000 calories because people say that. You know, just focus on eating enough food, training hard, and you will grow. The gains are definitely going to come. Okay, the last question is something that makes me proud of myself. I don't know, I feel like that's a very difficult question. I feel like that's a question other people have to answer for me.
No.
I'm proud of the person I've become, where I've come from to where I am now. The fact that I can cook, I'm proud of that. The fact that I can hit those 260 kilos, I'm very proud of that. I'm proud of myself. Yeah, that's the last thingy, that's the last question. Please like, comment, subscribe, follow me on Instagram. Like, comment, subscribe. If you watch the whole thing, thank you. It means a lot to me. Share it. Tell your friends about me. Tell your friends to tell their friends about me. See you guys in the next video.